Hi, welcome to this brief tutorial about the general settings of FFmpeg Patch AV Converter. First of all, we will add some files. And the first thing we will see is the presets editor and the parameters. A preset is a collection of some FFmpeg parameters and an output format. Here we can edit the presets list. We can remove any of them or add a new one. For example, this one. And there, for example, and we also put this output form. There we go. This is our new preset. We can also edit here it on the fly. If we want to make this preset the default one when we start the application, we can click on Save Settings. And every time we select a different preset, we can go back to the default with reload settings. We can try that these parameters are okay with the try preset button. If we put any wrong or unknown parameter and try it, we will get an error message. So we reload it. We could also change the format here. Here we could see the last queue session, the last encoding session, in case we obtain any error. And for example, we can save the queue status as a new file. So in case we want to resume our encoding queue, we can go here to File, Load Queue File, and get it here. And there we would go. The default most typical choice to encode is sequential encoding. Items are encoded one by one. We have enabled this check, so the preset is not tested every time we start encoding. A very useful choice, for example, for audio encoding is multi-file. We will start processing, in this case, two files at the same time. But since we already processed some of them, we get this warning. We continue anyway. And there we go. And we obtain this output folder. One interesting thing is that during sequential processing, we can add new files or folders. For example, we can add a new one, and total progress is automatically updated. Okay. We can also apply up to three different presets to our files, so we want to convert them to different formats like FAC, MP3, or WAV. There we would go. After trying the presets and getting this warning about already encoded items, we continue, and there we go. As we can see here, we are encoding preset 1 of 3. Only sequential processing is supported in multiple presets future. There we go, presets 2 of 3. Anyway, we are going to abort. A very useful thing also is to skip a current encoding file. Also, can obtain multimedia information here or here. It is also possible to record the screen, but we need a properly defined screen recording, like this one's already saved. For example, here I can use the hardware encoder quick sync and then use capture device, change the device and start capturing. Join files is a way to concatenate all the files on the list using the parameters here. So if we want to make a single MP3 file with all these files, we can quickly click here, so all of them are converted to one single MP3 file. Okay. We can also use the quick trim feature, so we trim using this as the start and finish time. And if we click this check, depending on it, we will just cut the amount of time set here or using this as pointers, depending on our requirements. Another choices, another settings, for example, delete source files after successfully encoded. We can also overwrite source files if we choose a preset with the same output extension and we select the source files path. This will cause files to be overwritten. Let's go for it. So now we see that they display as replaced. That's it. This displays because we have this open on completion check enabled. We can also recreate the source files path onto the output path. We will reset it. We can also rename the output files adding this suffix. And many other settings are here, for example, include folders and their subfolders, enable log saving, as well as more reverse logs. Here we can choose between two concatenation filters depending on our requirements. We will get some information about any of them. This choice allows us during multi-file encoding to sort files starting with the short ones, starting with the long ones, so they are started to be encoded first. This is just not to try the files on console, but just open the console. This will remember the last tab we used. Check for updates. Remember window location. And all of these ones are available on the FFmpeg Batch IP Converter user guide. We also have network files catching settings, as well as the default preset here. In case we have some trouble or application starts behaving erratically, we can reset all settings. Anyway, this will delete any custom preset we created. And this is it. In another video, we will continue learning about the rest of the tabs of the application. Thank you very much.